Do you like ancient history? Like ancient structures, ancient inventions, ancient queens, new archaeological discoveries, theories surrounding the ancient world, or even human evolution? Then I suggest you subscribe to the channel, click that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload, and maybe consider becoming a Patreon or a channel member if you do enjoy my work. So if you know a little bit about my work, you know that I like ancient inventions. And some of you probably wondered if I am able to tie my ancient inventions videos and series with my new hominid videos and series. And yeah, I sure can, because if you know me a little bit, you would know that I often think about historic things. And if you have been watching me for a while, you know that my mind sort of, you know, revolves around ancient history, especially around ancient inventions and the first creation of things. So in the past few months, I have been researching human evolution and the human evolutionary timeline. And I've been wondering about this one thing: the oldest stone tools. When were the first stone tools created? Not just stones that were used as tools, because we do know they exist as well, but the creation of the actual first crude stone tools. My name is Kaylee, and in this video, I'm going to look at the stone tools that we know from a couple of million years ago, and the actual oldest stone tools ever discovered up until the creation of this video. Which means that if older stone tools will be discovered in the future someday, I will create a follow-up video to cover the oldest stone tools discovered up to date then. But let's start with a quick overview on the stone tools found at the Olduvai Gorge, because this is quite important. And this is also where the name of this type of stone tool comes from. And we work our way all the way back to the very oldest stone tools ever discovered. And it's gonna absolutely blow your mind when I tell you how old the oldest first created stone tools are that we have found up until now. So if you have seen my video about Homo habilis, thumbnail right here, you will already have heard me talk about the stone tools that were discovered at the Olduvai Gorge in Tanzania by Louis and Mary Leakey. These stone tools are known under two names. We have Mode 1 technology and the Oldowan Stone tools. And yeah, they were discovered in the 1930s by the Leakey archaeologists. The Olduvai Gorge is also known under the name of Olduvai and Oldowan Gorge. So it depends on who you ask what the name is, but yeah. Which is why the stones are called Oldowan stone tools instead of Olduvai stone tools. So like I said in the beginning, the Oldowan stone tools are not just a few tools. It's actually an entire industry or style of stone tools that spanned across a massive area around the globe. And when I say massive area, I really do mean massive. It's discovered in the following African countries. We have Ethiopia, Egypt, Algeria, Kenya, Tanzania, and South Africa. But the Oldowan stone tool industry wasn't just discovered in Africa, but in Europe as well, in countries like Georgia, Bulgaria, Russia, Spain, France, Italy, Germany, the Czech Republic, and Hungary. Not that you're hungry, it's the country, Hungary. And as you can imagine, these Oldowan stone tools were discovered in the Middle East in countries like Syria, Iran, and Israel. And it didn't stop there, because they were even discovered in Asia, in the country of China. And of course, as we all know, China's absolutely massive. So like I said, found in a massive area around the globe. So in this search, let's first look at the sites outside of Africa where the Oldowan stone tools were found. And after I've covered them all, I will tell you everything there is to know about the Oldowan stone tools on the African continent that were discovered, including the absolute oldest stone tools that were discovered, pushing back the timeline for the creation of the first stone tools by a massive amount of time. Nearly a million years. So let's start in China at the Xiudu site, which is an archaeological site dating from the Paleolithic. Researchers discovered a total of 32 stone tools here. Among these were choppers, scrapers, and three-edged tools. These tools date back to approximately 1.8 million years ago. In Iran, approximately 80 different stone tools were discovered across 7 sites in the Kashafrut Basin, which is yet another archaeological site dating from the Lower Paleolithic. The stone tools discovered in Iran date from approximately 1.8 million years ago. So many of the tools found here resembled the East African Oldowan Stone tools. The tools they found here were choppers, flakes, chunks and hammer stones, and most of these tools here were made from quartz, and they showed a high level of skill from the toolmakers. In Syria, at the Ain al-Fil archaeological site dating from the Lower Paleolithic, a plethora of Oldowan stone tools were discovered as well, and these tools date from between approximately 2 and 1.8 million years ago. Some of the discovered tools here show little sign of modification, although there are quite a lot of tools here that are distinctly bifacial and even trifacial choppers. These tools here are amongst the oldest in the entire Middle East, and they're in the middle of the Syrian desert, and the discovery of these particular tools in this particular location have raised numerous questions about which path the early hominins actually took. Because for a very long time, it was believed that the early hominins traveled only along the Mediterranean through modern-day Israel. But it now seems that there was a second alternative route through, you know, the modern-day Syrian desert. But now that I've mentioned modern-day Israel, we can look at the Bizat Ruhama site in Israel, where evidence was found surrounding the complexity of the stone tool creation process, which apparently was a lot more complex than the researchers initially thought. This led to a new perspective on the skills and the capabilities of the invention and adaptability of the hominin populations that actually created these stone tools. So these tools discovered here at the Bizat Ruhama site date back to approximately 2.4 million years ago, which is a long time ago. So the researchers here discovered a lot of secondary flakes as well. And this actually led the team to believe that the secondary flakes were an intentional response to raw material constraints. This probably has to do with the fact that in a relative short time frame, the site had been occupied several times. And yeah, that can lead to shortage of, you know, crude material. The Oldowan stone tools discovered in Italy were found at the Montepoiolo site and date to approximately 850,000 years ago. And they are actually the oldest evidence of human occupation in Italy. The Oldowan stone tools in Germany were discovered in river gravels at Karlich and date from 300,000 years ago. So the tools in the Czech Republic were discovered in an ancient lake deposit at Přizletice, and they have been found at Stranská skála in a cave site as well. They date from approximately 500,000 years ago, and the tools discovered in Hungary were found at Vertesolos and also date from 500,000 years ago. And if I butcher any of these names, then please do not come for me in the comments. They are very difficult. In Spain, the Oldowan stone tools were discovered at Fuente Neva, number 3, at Barranco del León, Cima del Elefante, and at Atapuerca. In Russia, although to be completely correct, the Republic of Dagestan, which is a Russian republic in the North Caucasus, and yeah, here are numerous sites where Oldowan stone tools were discovered, dating from between 1.8 to 1.2 million years ago. In Bulgaria, Oldowan stone tools were discovered at the Kozarnica site with a human molar, and this is dated to date from between 1.6 and 1.4 million years ago. In Georgia, the Oldowan stone tools were discovered at Dmanisi, which I mentioned in my Homo erectus video. These tools were actually discovered along with 2 Homo erectus skulls, and the layer in which the skulls and the tools were found, it was just filled with hundreds of Oldowan stone tools and a lot of animal bones. And this archaeological layer dates to approximately between 1.8 and 1.6 million years ago. The Dmanisi site is extremely important as it is the earliest and oldest evidence for the presence of early humans outside of the African continent, outside of Israel, because they would have traveled along Israel to get there. It showed that Homo erectus left the African plains at the earliest of 1.8 million years ago to go to Europe, which is only around 100,000 years after they first emerged in the fossil record. That's when the oldest fossils were discovered in Africa, dating from 1.9 million years ago. So now it's time to quickly go over the sites in Africa where the stone tools were discovered. And after that, I will finally reveal the very oldest discovered Oldowan stone tools up until this day. So first, let's start in Ethiopia. In the Afar Triangle, in the Hadar region, some of the oldest Oldowan stone tools were found. And these date to approximately 2.6 million years ago. And recent excavations actually have surfaced tools that are associated with cut marks on bones, suggesting that some of the tools discovered here were used in the process to acquire meat. Another site in Ethiopia is at the Shungura formation of the Omo River basin, and the tools here date to approximately 1.4 million years ago. And yet another site in Ethiopia. I mean, Ethiopia has a lot of Oldowan stone tools. But yeah, another site in Ethiopia is at the Melka Kuntura in the Upper Awash Valley. And the tools discovered here date to approximately 1.7 million years ago. In Egypt, Oldowan stone tools were discovered as well. And they were discovered along the Nile River. And these tools here date to approximately 2 million years ago. In Algeria, we have discovered Oldowan stone tools at the Ain Boucherit site in Serif. These actually date from between 2.4 and 1.9 million years ago. In Tanzania, as I mentioned in my Homo habilis video, the Oldowan stone tools were discovered at the Oldowan or Olduvai Gorge. And the tools discovered here date from between 1.8 and 1.53 million years ago. In South Africa, we have the limestone cave known as the Sterkfontein site. The Oldowan stone tools that were discovered here date from between 1.8 and 1.1 million years ago. At the Zwartkrans site in South Africa, again, is a cave where many Oldowan stone tools were discovered. And these tools actually date from between 1.8 and 0.5 million years ago. In Kenya, on the Homa Peninsula, we have the Kanjera site complex, where Kanjera South is located. This site is approximately 2 million years old, and numerous Oldowan stone tools were discovered here. In East Turkana, in Kenya, we have the Kubifura site, which I actually mentioned in my Homo habilis video as well. This is where Oldowan stone tools were discovered as well. And these date to approximately 1.9 and 1.7 million years ago. In West Turkana, still in Kenya, we have the Nachukui site, which housed some of 500 Oldowan stone tools, dating to between 1.8 and 1.7 million years ago. And now finally, we have reached that moment. It is finally time for the big reveal. The very oldest created Oldowan stone tools that have been discovered as recently as 2015. They were discovered in West Turkana in Kenya at the Lomekwi 3 site, and they date to approximately 3.3 million years ago. This means that before Homo erectus, before Homo habilis, before any of the species in the Homo genus existed, these stone tools were already being created and used, which means that one or more of the species in the Australopithecus genus is responsible for creating and using these stone tools, which means that the invention of stone tools predates all human species that have ever existed on the planet, according to the fossil records that we have. And that just honestly absolutely blows my mind. So what do you think about this piece of information? How do you feel knowing that it was 3.3 million years ago that the oldest and first stone tools were being made? Let me know in the comments down below. But with that said, you have reached the end of this video. If you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified whenever I upload. Because I do that whenever I want. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner or a link in the description down below, or click a video in the end card. I cater to you. Enough choice, for real. I want to thank all my patrons and my channel members because I'm eternally grateful for all your support. And it's making my life a little bit easier, especially now that I have to pay rent soon, which kind of stresses me out. But yeah, when you see this, I'll be in England, which is fun because I love England. I have a wedding, which is why I have my beautiful white nails and I'm all prepared. I've got my medieval dress and everything because it's a medieval themed wedding. I mean, you don't make that up. I'm going to England to a medieval themed wedding. And I'm going to have the time of my life. Insert dirty dancing music. But yeah, no. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.